Hi, I'm Katrin. Welcome to my channel. My passion is storytelling, and that is what you find on my channel. I do the overall story of Margit Sandemo's book series The Legend of the Ice People. It's a fantastic family saga which extends over several centuries. That is what I'm going to look into in my video today. Every book in this story stands on its own. You can come into the story any time. So far we have followed Sol's journey from the Lindale to Copenhagen in Denmark and from Copenhagen to Skåne. She is traveling with a king's man. On that journey she gets kidnapped and rescued by Jakob Skille, which she later finds herself in bed with. She visited the hills of Brösarp, the place Hanna have told her about. She found the place, but she was too late. All the witches were gone. It was about 60 years since they changed place for their meetings. Now she need to find Anska's gorge instead. Sol got the direction from an old couple and continued to look for that place. She is also looking for the herb black nightshade that she needs for her trip to Blåkulla. On their way to Tollarp, she heard voices in the forest. She found a group of soldiers catching a young woman. When Sol heard her cry, she came to her rescue. Meta, the young woman, explains the way to Anska's gorge. But before Sol continued the journey on her own, she made sure that Meta was thoroughly cleaned. She was now free from both lice and fleas. Meta warned her about the abyss and who lives there. But Sol was not worried at all. She is more eager and expectant. Sol found both Anska's gorge and three people who turned out to be exactly like herself. They welcomed her. From the other witches she learned three important things. She was not alone in Norway with her knowledge. Forest Finns have made their way through Sweden and into Norway, and they have a great knowledge in witchcraft. She was also told that she had to hurry home. Someone needs her help. And the third is why they are called the Ice People. It was not because of the Valley of the Ice People, no. It's because they have ice in their hearts. They cannot love. She learned a lot during that night. She inhaled a potion, which made it possible to meet descendants. She saw her mother and father. She also saw Silje from the night when she saved her. It was good memories, but then Tengel the evil appears. She begins to feel panic and she shouts to her father Tengel that she needs help. At home in Norway, he wakes up. He knew she needed his help. Both him and Silje tries to help her. When the night was over, the three witches turned back home again. Sol decided to stay a bit longer. It's time for her trip to Blåkulla. Back home in Norway, Liv had married Lorenz Berenius. Liv realized almost immediately that this marriage will not be a happy one. Every day it gets worse and worse. I will start up where I left Sol the last time. She is at Blåkulla. She have just met the devil. What Sol experienced now cannot compare with anything she have experienced before. She became completely dizzy and did not even notice that she flew through the air until she woke up under the tree. She woke up with a headache from another world. She could not move her head. It was evening. She was nauseous and had difficulty moving. She tried to lie still. It hurt in her abdomen too. She had a burning desire to experience it again. Oh, she thought, now I can teach Jakob a thing or two. The headache was far too disgusting. She turned around mourning. She must try to get rid of it. This was probably the price you had to pay. She used all her strength to find something in her medicine supply, a sleeping pill. She took it and finally she fell asleep and slept all night. The next morning she was well again. She must find a cure before she goes on another trip to Blåkulla. She doesn't want to experience such pain again. Now she was about to pick up Meta. She had a bad conscience while riding through the forest of Lindrödsåsen and down to the valley by the river. When she got there, everything was quiet, unnaturally quiet. The water was shiny, it rippled lightly. The waterfall made it sound like sweet music and everything bathed in blazing sunshine. Not a sign of life. Sol became cold. Imagine if she, in her self-preoccupation, had driven the young woman into inhospitable wasteland. Or if there really were wild boars or other predators here. Meta, she shouted. Meta, it's me, Sol. Something was moving up on the cliff. She saw a small figure stand up. Oh, my God, Meta, now you scared me. I thought you were panicking and running away. Sol jumped off the horse. How have you been? Meta looked pretty pale. The forest was awful at night and the moon was staring at me. But you're used to being alone, right? Not so far away from people. Do you have any food left? I'm really hungry now. Meta looked guilty. She had eaten most of it. With a sigh, Sol took half of the leftovers and then they left the place. How far is it to Fulltofta? Oh, that's a long way there. We must go that way, Meta showed the direction. That's the wrong way to go. We do not have time for that, said Sol. I must meet one of my travelling companions, and I'm already late. Bosjökloster, then. It's in the same direction, but even further away. Then we only have Vittskövle left, then. Meta did not respond. While they rode, Meta sat quietly behind Sol. She answered when she was addressed. What is it? Said Sol, irritated. They say that the old lady at Vittskövle is terribly hard on the maids. I do not dare to go there, miss. Who is she? Her name is Jörvel, father's daughter. She has been married 3 times. Now she is the widow of Brahe, and she is the richest in all of Skåne. She is over 90 years old, but she is sharp as a hawk. Let me be your maid. I do everything for you. My what? Stammered Sol, amazed. Sol laughed. To be her maid, who does she think she is? Meta, listen to me now. I'm just an ordinary person. I am not noble and I have never stayed in the same place for a long time. But I promise you, you will not end up in Vittskövle. I found another place for you. It doesn't matter if you're not a noble lady, and I would never ask for a salary. All I want is to work for you, so I can pay back for the good you have given me. Sol felt suddenly annoyed. She was not a good person. But then a thought popped into her head. Silje, she thought, or Charlotte, they have servant in their home. But bring this young woman around the country and kingdom all the way to Norway. Well, we'll see, said Sol. What will Jakob think about this, she thought worriedly. And I, who have been looking forward to meet him again. When they came to the edge of the hills of Brösarp, Sol saw a riding approaching. It was Jakob Skille. She stopped the horse and said hello as he approached. What are you doing here? Well, I could not wait any longer. He felt silent when he saw Meta sitting behind her on the horse. His mouth sank down in disappointment. This is Meta. She is homeless and I will try to place her with nice people. He nodded bitterly and turned the horse. He looks mundane, she thought. He is robust and masculine, of course, but compared to the Prince of Darkness. He is rather bland. Well, it was nice to see him again. He told her which road they will take now. There is a road who pass through Skåne. But we have to pick up Jörgen, right? Sure, we'll get there. They passed a couple of large farms on their way, but it was Meta managed to find thousands reasons not to look for work there. This one is haunted, or no one lives there, and so on. Sol realized very well that Meta could not know anything about this estate, but she left her alone. They spent the night on a farm in a barn far out in the fields where no one can see them. Meta turned out to be awkward. She wanted to hold Sol's hand. She was worried that her hero-ness will disappear again. And Jakob was overly annoyed and had a hard time not showing it. In the darkness, Jakob had worked his way closer to Sol. When he heard that Meta's breath was beginning to calm down, he gently caressed Sol's face. "I have missed you terribly," he whispered in her ear. "Hush," whispered Sol. "She is sleeping. Let's go out." Sol rose to half, and Meta immediately lifted her head. "What is it? Where are you going, miss?" "Nowhere. I just try to settle down better." She hugged the young woman's hand. "I am here all the time." Meta calmed down again.
"I was looking forward to meet you again," Jakob whispered, endlessly disappointed.
"But I did too," Sol whispered back.
"This is our only chance. Tomorrow we meet Jörgen again, and then we cannot be alone."
"Jakob, I could not do otherwise."
"If I were to pick up every single beggar."
"There was something special about Meta. I can't tell you now. Try to sleep. We must ride far tomorrow."
"But I want to be alone with you now."
"Yes, I know, and I feel the same way. Good night." He puts his arm around her waist. Sol moved it away, kindly but firmly. She heard him swear a long rhyme. Then he turned his back to her. Sol woke up at dawn and sat up. "Jakob, Meta is not here." He turned around.
"How nice! Then we can be for ourselves."
"No, don't be so selfish. We have to find her."
"Why? If you want to go, let her do so. People like her have 9 lives."
"Not Meta. She's helpless, like an infant. When I found her, she was wearing thin rags and she had not eaten for a week.
12 large, brave soldiers have bound her and was about to having fun with her." "Oh, Lord, why did you not say anything?"
"But when would I have the opportunity to do so? She was next to me all the time." She got up. "Look here. She have put a bouquet of flowers at her sleeping place." "She wanted to thank me, I think. But why did she suddenly go her way?"
"We must find her," said Jakob. "Then we must try to find a good place for her to work."
"Thank you, Jakob." Sol stopped and put her hands around his neck. "You're nice," she whispered and kissed him lightly. Jakob hugged her tightly and kissed her with a hunger that told a lot about his longing. They left the barn and rode through groves and meadows. They went back the same way they came from. They expect Meta to do the same. She had come a long way, but in the end they found her. A pathetic little person who was blinded by all the crying. Jakob jumped off his horse. "Meta, why did you do so?" said Sol. Meta turned away and she could not answer because of all her crying. Jakob lifted Meta up behind Sol.
"But I thought it was best," mumbled Meta. So you two could be alone."
"Okay." Sol looked at Jakob. She had apparently heard them. Jakob was more human than she thought.
Meta, you misunderstand us last night. We do not want to get rid of you. There was only one thing that Sol and I needed to discuss, secrets concerning Denmark. But it can wait. They rode next to each other because the road was wide right there.
Do you know what I discovered? Said Sol. Now I discover I can't leave you here. We missed you so much, so I plan to take you home with me, to my kind mother in Norway. What do you say about that?
Meta hugged Sol so hard that she almost lost her breath.
Do you know where Norway is located?
Maybe behind the forest over there, Meta guessed.
Yes, in a way. But you also have to cross the sea. You must go by both day and night.
But isn't that dangerous?
Not when I am with you, said Sol.
I think that we stop here for today.
So Meta will follow her back home to the Lindale. That's a great idea. A better place cannot be found for poor Meta.
So it's time to go home now. That means that we soon will see who needs Sol's help.
But first they have a bit of a journey left. They are on their way to pick up Jörgen.
Next on my channel I will look into Fear the Walking Dead's SS Pennsylvania. The episode is mostly about Morgan and Victor, who tries to stop Teddy and Riley. They are about to end the world. Then I will continue with Margit Sandemo's book series The Legend of the Ice People and the book Stepdaugher, The Abyss. Some of my videos are published for a long time, others are removed quite quickly. If you don't want to miss anything or if you just want to support my channel, subscribe and click on the notification bell. I wish you a wonderful day. Thank you so much for stopping by. Stay safe out there and welcome back.